what makes a person feel like, you know,
they need to step out of their marriage. Yes. So there's my husband, the father, and there's my husband, my dude, and I still have to date him. I still have to love on him. I still have to put on those sexy panties.
I have been that kind of a situation where I know this is going.
Welcome back to our channel. It's the Mona for Mamas. So today we're going to be talking about the kind of relationship that has an extra person on the side, okay? AKA a triad. More so, we're going to focus on the fact that the second person knows that there's a third party in the relationship and does nothing about it, or rather accommodates it. So, Sarah, Ebu start us off on this topic of, like an extra person.
And, you know, what causes it? What makes a person feel like, you know,
they need to step out of their marriage? Yes.
And the one thing that comes to my mind is finances to me. Finances, because say when you got into a relationship, what your husband was working.
Yeah.
And you were at home, right?
Yeah.
And then things happened. Probably you are going to school. You graduated. Now you get a job, right? A more paid job than your husband.
Yes.
And so he feels like, oh my gosh, you know, you're up there. You're not paying attention to him, and you become a threat to him.
Yes.
And so instead of talking to you about it, it goes out into your marriage and try to look for somebody else.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Going in line with what you're saying, not only is it because he feels threatened, there's some people who say the woman, right? Once she gets this better paying job, starts to talk down to a man. So you emasculate him. So now he has the need to feel like a man again. And therefore he goes out there to find somebody that will allow him to be a man. Somebody that still sees him as, you know, the one.
So then do you, at that point, in that kind of a situation, is it you blame the wife then?
I would blame both parties, because no matter what's going on in your marriage, we married each other, right? It's our covenant with God, right? Or whoever you worship. So, I mean, I blame the person, whether it's man or woman, who is belittling the other. Then I blame the person who's stepping outside to find their comfort zone instead of finding a way to communicate with their partner about, this is what's going on, this is how I feel, why are we now in this space? Okay? Because I think in a healthy relationship, it doesn't matter who makes the most money. What matters is the ultimate goal. We're dipping the money in this pool to increase us and to better our children's future. Who cares who brings the money home?
What else do you think that can be causing that? What are the things that come to your mind?
Definitely, as a new mommy, I will say that if you don't rein it in and if you don't have control, new children can be a thing. Just because I feel like you're used to being the two of you, right? Then all of a sudden there's a baby. And as a mom, your instinct is my baby, my baby, my baby. But I won't even say as a mom, because I watch my husband and his instinct is always the baby, the baby, the baby. So you still have to find a part of you that can pull out your relationship, right? So there's my husband, the father, and there's my husband, my dude. And I still have to date him. I still have to love on him. I still have to put on those sexy.
So how do you do that for you? How do you do that?
Girl, adoreme.com got the best lingerie, and it's cheap. Or yandy.com. I'm just saying, this ain't even a paid promotion. If I can't still be that chick he liked, that chick he fell in love with, that chick he used to want to tap all the time, then yeah, he's going to get bored. Same for me. If all my husband sees me as his mom, which mom is a great, it's a wonderful title, right?
Yeah.
But as his wife, if he forever sees me as mom, like, what happens to my inner freak? Like, that girl needs a scratch too. So listen, people, keep it spicy anyway. It doesn't matter. Keep your person interested. Date them. Talk to them. Because that's the biggest thing. You're all rushing. Okay, you got to work. Somebody's got to sit with the baby. But we still got to find our calm.
And, you know, and especially being here, taking care of the children is draining. Can be draining. It is difficult. And sometimes you find yourself not having any more energy to entertain anything else.
Yeah.
So having those moments, even if it's, you know, go out, there's a two of you, you know.
Rediscovering my best friend. Like, it's gotta be there. Because, for example, like I feel for my husband, because he just spent, 9-10 months watching me throw up, get fat, complain about it. He needs to see his girl who before that, like, was down to go to a party, down to go on a road trip. But, you know, that girl still needs to be in there somewhere in the midst of being a mom. So, on top of that, once we've established this is what's going on, you're working on your marriage and all this, my biggest issue is the people who know that this is going on. They know that person is stepping out, and then they don't do anything about it. I just don't know how they have the energy to sit. Because, you know, okay, so I believe there's the random cheater. There's the guy or chick It doesn't matter. Akwe Mombasa, akwe America, akwe Germany. They will always find somebody that is not their person.
And you know, it doesn't. Okay, well, mostly it's men, you know, in that particular kind of a situation. But you also have, as a wife, you will always have that gut feeling. Something is not right. You don't have to wait until you catch them, because you may never catch them.
But can we talk about that gut feeling? And I've had my boys refer to, which I really hate. They always call girls crazy, eh? Topic for another day, but I feel guys call you crazy once you no longer do what they want you to do. But there's chicks who are actually, me, I've seen crazy chicks. I've seen chicks who have this gut feeling no matter what's going on in life. Gut feeling. There's the real gut feeling, and the person who, though I do believe a lot of it comes from someone who's been hurt over and over and over, right? So they're never able to sit in a relationship without wondering, is this person doing something somewhere else?
Like what you said about the healing, because one of the reasons why you need to talk about the causes is because you need your own healing too. Because if you just decide now, they have been cheating, I need to leave, you did not solve that situation, you might carry that forward into your next relationship. So it's important. Yes. So back to the gut feeling. I mean, I'm not talking about every little thing. You're going through the phone, you're going through the emails. No, that's being insecure though.
It is. And we have a very large majority of us. And then again, social media age, right? There's so many ways to cheat now, because cheating now is relative. But for some people, I didn't really physically touch the person, it's nothing. But if you're having a whole emotional relationship with somebody else, that's cheating. Okay? Yeah. If you're talking to somebody about our problems and all, that's cheating. But everybody has their own thing. So besides the random cheating, there's women who've accepted. Now they just know, tunajuanga tu nani anakonga, wajoni anakonga, it is what it is. And they stay. You know, more power to you, sis, but I can't. There's the guy who has a permanent fixture on his side, but no one ever really says anything. You know that friend of yours who always brings a chick who is not his wife or not his fiance or not his long-term girlfriend, and I'm letanga kwa bash. If you have a Lura show, he brings her. If you guys have a weekend getaway as couples, he brings that chick. But you guys know on Facebook, his chick is this other chick. Okay,
Yule, I feel like that one Yule amewekwa, I guess. Are you talking about that one? Yule amewekwa, you know, you know, even that the in-laws know that there's a kind of a situation going on there.
But that's horrible. But, I can't.
But with that though, V, there's respect for the first wife.
Okay, no. Okay, so I get what you're saying. You're talking about Yule ni bibi wa pili tumekubali. Right?
We
have introduced your in-laws, the main wife knows, even our kids are put on a boarding school, look into one and really an soda because they know the brother. Yeah. So there's that one. But there's also the chick who is brought out for events because you, the wife, the mom, is at home with the kids. And all his boys know this ain't his wife. But nobody ever says anything. All his boys, girls know this ain't the wife. Okay?
Okay. And mom knows the one who is always whispered that they know something is going on. Okay. Yeah.
She's always just around. And no one says anything. We smile, we take pics, we go on vacations to Naivasha, and then dude goes back home to start the week on Monday. Annoying as hell. And then, of course, like the one you said who's been introduced, because, of course, Kenya allows polygamy. See, it was signed into law or something like that. Mm-hmm. You only need to sign polyandry into law so even us, we can have 2-3 husbands. Okay.
But if you're in kind of a situation like that where the one whispered, you know, they know that your husband has somebody somewhere, you know, if there's a bash, they go to that one. So he has, your husband has friends. Would you like to, your friends to tell you that, you know, come on, this is going on?
Oh, yeah. Yes, I want to know. I would like to
have,
but that's me, because personally, I wouldn't stay.
I have been that kind of a situation where I know this is going on, right? Mm-hmm. And to me, I'm thinking, do I want to break that family?
And the messed up part is, if they don't break up, they turn and look at you as the enemy. I understand what you're saying. I understand. Because I thought you up at Jersey, I remember when you served Mount Kenya. But I do know, I've gone to parties. I've asked my girlfriend to come with me. She can't come because, you know, her dude is not there. Then me, I go to the party and her dude is there. So I'm like, what do I do? Am I going to tell you, sis, your man is here? I mean, there's times where I'm like, you know what? Me, I didn't see you. You didn't see me. Life goes on. Because I'm just so confused. I think you have to have a certain relationship with the person. Like, if I saw your husband out, Sarah, I'll take pictures, I'll call you, make sure he sees me. Like, hey, boo, you see me, right? And there's some girls, I don't know. I really wouldn't know what
that's true.
I mean, those people who choose to stay, power to you, tolerate what you want to tolerate. It's not necessarily for me, but for those people who do choose to stay in such relationships, I think the most important thing to think about is, are you happy? Are you okay? If you as a person are able to tolerate, because like I said, generations have had polygamous, polyandrous relationships, the people who've grown happy and healthy. If you're okay, then that's fine. But do not sit in a place where you're not happy. Because children, no matter how young, they feel your energy, they carry with them. You're teaching them what kind of adults.
Especially that. Tell you about the children, because being a mother, being a parent is a noble thing. Yeah. We are never, you know, you always try to be the best you can. We are always coming short, but try to create a conducive environment, because the kids will tap into that energy real quick. And what kind of a role model are you trying to be to your children?
So guys, do what you gotta do. Just stay safe. Okay, wrap it up. I'm just saying, don't be out here giving kids to everybody. The Rona is around. Be safe. Know who you're laying down with. And like I said, if you happy, sis, bro, you know what? Enjoy your relationship. You know, as for me and my house, we will be monogamous. Nothing. Thank you for tuning in today, guys. Like, subscribe, and share. And we'll see you next time on the Mod Apple.
Yes, bye-bye.